It's high time to toss your coin to your bookkeeper. Welcome to the Bookkeeping Superstar. And today, I was asked a question. In connection to our previous discussion on conquering with cash discounts, which you can check it over here, we're going to determine now the discount periods. A very important aspect in any merchandising setup, especially for early payments or early collections made by the clients. So stick around, everyone, because today we are going to debunk your discount periods. To determine the discount periods, we need the following: the date of entry in which the transaction started, and the different credit terms set by your supplier or you as an owner to your clients. Since we are looking for a range of dates, we will focus our attention to the denominators of each credit term, as it can help us determine the correct discount period. For the first credit term, basically all we can do is add the denominator with our date of entry. So 5 plus 1 equals 6. Therefore, the first discount period is from March 2 to March 6. For the second credit term, that would be 10 minus 5 equals 5 days. Another 5 days is extended. Therefore, 5 plus 6 equals 11. The second credit term, its discount period is from March 7 to 11. For the last and third credit term, basically 20 minus 10 equals 10. 10 remaining days to complete the transaction. Therefore, 10 plus 11 is 21. The discount period for the last credit term would be from March 12 to 21. Thank you for tuning in today's video. Please don't forget to leave a like, comment, share this video, and hit the notification bell and subscribe to my channel, The Bookkeeping Superstar. Till another BK episode, everybody.